good grammar, speaking big grammar, arguing who is Niger Delta, who is Biafra. Nigeria is already taking over. Fulani has taken over Nigeria completely. It is over. It is all over. Now, listen to this.
Not me talking. The president has said it to Nigerians already.
2021.
December 2021. That is essentially 2 years from now. That's what it is. So now, that's that. Now, phase two. And we really don't want to, because of our history, we don't want to get ahead of ourselves. Mm-hmm. We want to show Nigerians first that phase one is what we say it is. And this is
that we're
serious about what we're talking about. But phase two, just for our people to know, is that by December 2023, we're building right now. We're in the process of finalizing the financing, I should say, to be very precise, on a $2.8 billion gas pipeline. Because Mr. President has strategically seen, he's looking into the future, and he can see that oil is going to give way eventually. By 2040, oil is not going to be the commodity that it is right now. But what will still be a very hot commodity internationally is gas. So what Mr. President is doing is he's placing the Nigeria into a kind of a strategic pivot from oil, maximizing our oil production now while it's still hot, but ensuring that we use those resources to pivot more into gas. So we finished the FID, the financial investment, the final investment decision on NLNG Train 7. Now what that means, what that means for us is that one third of our total gas production in the nation today, one third of it is going to be added to the current total of gas that we're adding, just with this one added Train 7 that we're putting into place. So it's a very big deal. That's just one effort. So now we're building this $2.8 billion pipeline that's going to take, it's going to come from the Niger Delta through Ajaokuta into Kaduna, into Kano. Now, the medium term, and this is why I say the president is a visionary. People don't yet know, but they're going to be finding out as time goes on. The reason why he's constructing it is for two reasons. One, we need to industrialize northern Nigeria. It's very, very important for several reasons. For several reasons. Social reasons, economic reasons. It just, we need to do that. That's number one. Number two is we want to connect that gas pipeline up through Niger Republic into Algeria, Tunisia, and all of these North African countries that need our gas. They are dependent right now on insufficient gas supply from some other countries, and they have interest in making sure that we have this abundant gas, and that could be the future of the Nigerian economy. So instead of talking about oil revenues,
$2.8 billion project, it is not reflecting in the budget. $2.8 billion pipeline project, the Senate did not approve it. $2.8 billion project, at least if the Senate have approved it, we don't know. They have approved it in the secret. We are not aware. Nobody is aware. So the approval and the readings in the Senate must have been secret because nobody have talked about it. So $2.8 billion to lay pipeline. On that pipeline from Niger Delta is targeting at they have to achieve two things. One is industrialization of northern Nigeria. Industrialization of northern Nigeria. It is not industrialization of Nigeria. It did not say boosting the economy of Nigeria, rather industrialization of Nigeria. Two is to bring oil, gas to the northern Africa, where the jihadists that will come to fight for them will be coming from. The government that have already pledged to pump and supply them with jihadists to come and fight over Nigeria. That is, now they are going to compensate them with gas so that they don't have any business with Niger Delta. Are you hearing that? And by the way, the facial expression on those ladies, they are just priceless.
I'm talking about oil revenues and talking about...
We're
moving into agriculture. We're moving into solid mineral reasons. One, we need to industrialize northern Nigeria. It's very, very important for several reasons. One, we need to industrialize northern Nigeria. It's very, very important for several reasons. One, we need to industrialize northern Nigeria. It's very, very important for several reasons. One, we need to industrialize northern Nigeria. It's very, yes. very important for several, reasons. For several reasons. Social reasons, economic reasons. It just, we need to do that. That's number one. Number two is we want to connect that gas pipeline up through Niger Republic into Algeria, Tunisia, and that's all of these. Number one. Number two is we want to connect that gas pipeline up through Niger Republic into Algeria, Tunisia, and all of these North African
that's
countries.
Number one.
That. Number two is we want to connect that gas pipeline up through Niger Republic into Algeria, Tunisia, and all of these North African okay. countries.
Then.
Now, we're going to close financing on that with a Chinese firm within the next, I believe it's now 4 months from now. I think it's, we're expecting it around February or March to close on the finance. Now, once that is done, we begin construction. Now, on that pipeline, we're going to build three gas-fired power plants on that pipeline. Simultaneously, we're not waiting for the pipeline to finish. We're doing it together so that they finish together. So now what you're going to have is you're going to have a gas-fired power plant in Abuja, 1,350 megawatts. You'll have a gas-fired power plant in Kaduna, 1,350 megawatts, and another gas plant in Kano, 1,350 megawatts. You put that together, that's 4,000 megawatts.
One Nigeria people, one power plant in Abuja, another power plant in Kaduna, another power plant in Kano, because these three places are the only Nigeria.
We're going to build three gas-fired power plants on that pipeline. Simultaneously, we're not waiting for the pipeline to finish. We're doing it together so that they finish together. So now what you're going to have is you're going to have a gas-fired power plant in Abuja, 1,350 megawatts. You'll have a gas-fired power plant in Kaduna, 1,350 megawatts. And another gas plant in Kano, 1,350 megawatts. You put that together, that's 4,000 megawatts.
4,000
megawatts.
Now,
I ask you all to go and watch the Ahmedu Bello proclamation, philosophy, northernization of Nigeria. Nderi reri. The one Nigeria, Nderi reri. The governors, Nderi reri. Senators, Nderi reri. All the people shouting, one Nigeria, you have been scammed. You have been scammed. You have been scammed.
So guys, what do you think about this? What is your own take? The fact is that Nigeria is in a great mess right now. I'm telling you. And the problem that we have right now is that the Fulanis are taking over Nigeria entirely. And it is just so shameful that we have a leader that does not even show any concern at all. According to what this guy said, you know, he said it all. He said the truth. This is the problem that we are facing right now. Nobody to even stop the evil atrocities by the Fulani people in the country. But remember that Nnamdi Kanu said it before now. In fact, Nnamdi Kanu has said it like years back, maybe 2 years ago, talking about the Fulani people, talking about the Hausa people, and now it's coming to reality. And now the Fulanis, they want to take charge of the country by all means. They want to govern us by all means. They want to be in control. Because we have a leader that does not even show any concern at all. Buhari is just there with a figurehead. He's not even taking action. Instead of him to take action, he is supporting the Fulani people. Can you imagine this? Shows that President Muhammadu Buhari is happy with the way people are dying by the Fulani people. He is happy with the way the terrorist group in the north are killing the innocent people. It is only God that can help us. It is only God. Nnamdi Kanu said it all. Because this shows that, in fact, President Muhammadu Buhari is no more alive with the way we are seeing it right now. Because if you are really, really a citizen of Nigeria and you are the president of the country, definitely you will really, really show concern. Definitely you will not allow the bloodshed of the people to be wasted. But the reverse is the case. President Muhammadu Buhari is showing as if he's not part of the Nigerian people. It shows that as if he does not even have concern at all. He is happy with the way Fulani people are terrorizing the whole country. May God help us. This is not good at all. This is not a good thing. And Nnamdi Kanu has said it before now. This is a very big issue. It's a very big issue. And we are praying that God should take control of Nigeria. So guys, what do you think about this? What is your own take? Kindly drop your comments at the comment section below. For those who subscribe, we want to say a very, very big thank you to you for subscribing. We say God bless you. And if you're yet to do so, kindly press the subscription button below. And also, please don't forget to press the notification button so that whenever we upload news, of course, you will always be the first person to watch our latest news anytime, any day. God bless you. Have a lovely day. Bye.